Hi all, welcome back to Amazing Tech for All. Today we're going to be looking at TrueNAS again and seeing what other features or other things we can apply or deploy using TrueNAS. So let's log into TrueNAS. Yes, so the last video we had, we did a deployment of Firehole, which is a ad blocker and DNS. But this time around, let's take a look at it again. And these are some of the statistics. This is just for the last little bit. We haven't used it since. Log out of there. We are going to get rid of this by deleting it. Click delete. Remove the volumes. That volume as well. And there and delete. So that will stop the service and delete the Docker container that that has it in. So let's continue. Let's see what else is available. Now, another very good ad blocker, which I think may actually be better than Firehole, is AdGuard. So let's see if we can find AdGuard. AdGuard Home. There we go. Let's click on AdGuard. Now we can see some other suggestions, similar apps. Let's click on Install. Yeah. It asks us, there's a few questions that it asks, but one of the important things to click over here is the host network so that it will make it available on the, see, everything seems fine, uninstall. Excuse me. But once it starts up, it's going to give us, it's deploying, pull the image. Deploying the image now, and there the image is running. So we can, like with Firehole, we can click on the web UI. Web UI, and let go through the get started. And these are the interfaces that it will speak on. So we will be connecting to that one over there in the next few minutes. You can see that this addresses the port number is already in use. So we'll just do one there to see. Just for safety's sake, and then we'll click on next. Create the admin user, password for the admin user. Password, click on next, and now click on more time. We'll complete the Firehole deployment. So if we, sorry, not the pile, the AdGuard deployment. Save the password. Dashboard. Go. And this is admin and the password we just created. So this will give us similar functionality to Firehole. However, are some interesting settings over here, like the general settings. You can use this for your browser security. You can also use it as parental control and to ensure that safe search functionality so that you don't end up doing searches and you end up with content that is not appropriate for children. And that includes YouTube, Google, Bing, DuckDuckGo, and variety of other search engines. And that even includes, yeah, like I said earlier. Okay, and then another interesting feature is the, let's just see, I think it is blocking services. So here you have the ability to block a service, like for example, you could block AliExpress, or you can block Amazon streaming. You probably could block YouTube and ESPN and Facebook if you like, FIFA, just by a simple click of the button, and you can block that service for the entire period while it's in use. So we'll turn a client to point to this DNS and see if we can make it useful. Right. Save those. Let's just look at some of the other settings here. Your DNS settings. This is the DNS is going to query upstream. That's fine. And here's a few of the other DNSs, the bootstrap DNSs there as well. So I just wanted to confirm that that is in place. And then if we go back to filters, there's a DNS block list. You can find more block lists. We can do a check for updates. And there's another place to find. Choose from a list. There is a list of block lists that you can pick from. I'll just select this one over here, and we are away. But as you can see, the list has now been added to the block lists. Let's take a look at some of the other settings. See custom filters. You can also add things to the allow list. So if there's a specific domain that you want to ensure is allowed, that may be in the block list. We can, or one of the block lists, you can ensure that it goes through by adding to the allow list. Now you'll give it a name, you'll give it a URL, and that will then be allowed. So what we're going to do is try to connect a client or use this DNS, AdGuard as a DNS for the client. Let's take a look in the next few seconds, okay? In the case of Pile, we used a VM that's on the same subnet or the same network as the Pile server or the TrueNAS server that's running Pile. So what I'm going to do is I'm spinning up the same VM. I'm going to change the DNS also to point to the same one, just do the network configuration, edit connections. And what I'm going to do in the wired connection, I'm going to edit the connection, go to IPv4, and I'm going to change this to say address only. And I'm going to put the IP address for this DNS, which is a 192.168.122.131. Save it, close it, and then I'm going to restart my connection. Disconnect, and then I can reconnect. So we will start seeing data propagating through here. Here we've got our first few DNS requests as shown. Yes, and we haven't even gone onto a website yet. And we will now take a look, see how well this is doing. So we can go onto Google and we minimize this screen and refresh the statistics. You'll see all the DNS queries that's been logged against it. And the 7 items were blocked. That was just by going to Google. So let's take a look at the queries that or the block services that we have. Let's for example, see if we can block YouTube, right? So we'll save that. And let's go here and go to YouTube.com. In fact, there we go. We've got a little link there. Click on that, and we are unable to go to YouTube, right? Because the DNS is not allowing that through. Let's take a look and see. There's more content that was blocked because we attempted to go to YouTube. So let's go back to the filters, blocked services, and let's go to undo the YouTube. As I recall, I think we blocked Facebook as well. Yes. So we'll first save that. Let's go back here. Let's refresh YouTube. Let's see if any luck. It may take a few more seconds. It may take a little while, in fact. Let's see if we can go on to somewhere else on the other. We had no trouble going into Google. Let's see. Cats. Oh. Okay. Let's just click on this verification that I'm a human, not a robot, and we should see cats. That's fine. I wonder if we'll be able to see videos here now. Let's go. That's a YouTube video. Does it take us there? Now we are able to go to YouTube. Let's just try this again. We are now able to go to YouTube. So it takes a few seconds for the settings to kick in. So now we can see we've got a cat on YouTube. Let's go to AdGuard settings again. Oh, we wanted to go see Facebook. See, can we get to Facebook.com? We are unable to get to Facebook. Let's go there. Let's go untick the restrictions on Facebook. Like again, this will take a few seconds or maybe a minute or we are able to go onto it again. Let's just see. Maybe if we do it through Google, we'll say ads. We'll just do something random just to see if we can get to it. Not under videos. Let's see, maybe there's a Facebook group. There we go. It looks like we have one. And now suddenly we are able to get to Facebook. And if we refresh here, the expectation is still not. I put a www there. Yep, we are into Facebook now. So, as you can see, AdGuard is able to conveniently block a myriad of services, and I'm not sure, but there may be an opportunity. In fact, you can even set a schedule, say when a particular service must be allowed to be online or offline. There's a log for all the queries that was done. So who was the queries done by? You can see all the queries are done by a specific machine. That is the PC that we, the VM that we're using to test it with. So yes, that's a short video on deploying AdGuard on TrueNAS and using some of the features of AdGuard to ensure a better experience on the internet. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. And please remember to like and subscribe if you find this content useful. Thank you very much.